July, a time for some fun in the sun, a time for picnics in the park, backyard barbecues, and lounging at the ocean shore. When many make a splash in the refreshing waters of a lake, pond, or pool to escape the heat of a sweltering afternoon. July is blue, cloudless skies, and warm, starry nights. And perhaps a little less excitingly, begins the season of the brain-eating amoeba. And wouldn't you know it, fresh water warmed under the heat of the summer sun is its habitat of choice. But don't panic just yet about your chances of contracting one. The term brain-eating amoeba should be unsettling, as that's exactly what Naegleria fowleri does. Dissolve and feast upon one of our most critical organs. Truth be told, brains are not normally its preferred source of food. Generally, it's content to engulf bacteria in the water and soil. However, once in the human body, it adapts to its new environment, and tragically for those it infests, bodily tissues instead. It's common knowledge that we need our brains to survive. Naegleria fowleri kills, and it does so quickly. Its point of entry is the nose. Pretty much any activity where water goes into the nostrils could result in an infection. This includes things such as swimming, diving, and simply lowering one's head under the water's surface. People have become infected by falling into the water at recreational parks or soaking in popularly frequented hot springs. More than one individual died from clearing their sinuses with a neti pot. The FDA has warned the public about the improper use of the device. The good news is that the brain-eating amoeba is destroyed within our stomach acid. Drinking contaminated water will not cause an infection. It's not believed to be spread through mist or water vapor either, as from the shower or a humidifier. Not contagious, it will not transfer from person to person. When water is properly treated, as in chlorinated pools and most municipal water supplies, the amoeba will die. Beachgoers will be happy to know that salt water is safe as well. But that's pretty much where the good news ends. Once inside the body of its victim, Naegleria fowleri migrates up the olfactory nerve of the nose, attracted to the chemicals released by the cells as they communicate. This nerve serves as a pathway to the frontal lobe of the brain. Upon arrival, the amoeba will then create a substance that eats away the surrounding nerves and cells. It damages tissues yet further with structures known as food cups that it uses as it eats. The inspection of an infected brain has shown large sections turned to mush. The damage the amoeba causes is catastrophic and almost always fatal. It's fast-acting as well. It may only take 2 days to around 8 for symptoms to develop. These are quite often similar to those for viral meningitis and include headaches, a stiff neck, fevers, loss of appetite, seizures, and eventually coma. Some may begin to hallucinate or experience blurred vision and a loss of taste as well. Once an individual develops symptoms, death takes place just 3 to 7 days later. There is little warning, and by the time the cause is known, it's often too late. In addition, there's presently no known cure. Many theoretically promising treatments that work well in a laboratory setting appear to be less effective on actual people. Almost all patients administered these substances will still die. The fortunate few who have survived required multiple forms of therapy over an extended period of time. Even then, some had brain damage. Medical experts recommend avoiding situations where an infection may occur as the best bet to stay safe. This means not swimming, diving, or jumping into warm, stagnant waters in the summer months, or when playing around in such waters to wear preventative nose clips. Make sure not to disturb the mud along the banks either, as this is also where the amoeba may be found. Further, it can survive at much lower temperatures within the soil than in water, and so remains a threat for longer, cooler weather. Finally, neti pot users should heed the advice of the FDA and use only sterile or distilled water when irrigating their sinuses. However, the experts also claim that there is little reason to panic. They say that few cases of the disease caused by Naegleria fowleri each year are disproportionately sensationalized in the media, and further, that they are rare. Therefore, it comes as a surprise that studies have shown that the amoeba is pretty much everywhere. In fact, research by the Centers for Disease Control, or CDC, suggests that many in the general population have antibodies to Naegleria fowleri and were exposed to it previously, but their immune systems fought it off. It's unknown why so many survive exposure while others go on to develop a serious disease. Yearly infections occur at a documented rate from 0 to 8 cases, and these usually occur in the months of July, August, or September as the weather warms. However, this statistic only uses formally reported data. There's reason to believe cases are underrepresented as a result. A study of those who died from meningitis in Virginia found that 5 out of 16,000 bodies had previously undetected indications of the amoeba. Interestingly, of known cases, it affects some groups more than others. More than 66% of cases within the United States involve children 13 or younger. The cause for this may be due to their anatomy, as one of the structures amoebas must pass through is more permeable in children than in adults. Approximately 80% of cases are also males. This may mean one of two things. Either male children are particularly vulnerable to the brain-eating amoeba, or young boys are more likely to engage in activities that will lead to them getting contaminated water up their nose. Further trends reveal that cases occur more commonly in the southern United States. In general, the amoeba loves warm to hot waters and can withstand temperatures that reach up to 113 degrees Fahrenheit. Unfortunately for southern residents, this makes the hotter regions in which they live prime real estate for the amoeba. The threat, though not widespread, is a serious one. Of those who have developed a brain-eating disease, whatever the exact number may be, only 7 are known to have lived. 4 of these cases were in North America, 1 in Mexico, and the others in the United States. All were given several treatments, and 1 used hypothermia as a form of therapy. In other words, an infection with a brain-eating amoeba, save drastic measures and a whole lot of luck, is almost always fatal. Now the following question remains. Should you be afraid? Knowing what you know now, that incidents of infection are quite low, yet perhaps underreported, that this amoeba is everywhere, yet you may have developed its antibodies, and that you are far more likely to die from dozens of other things, yet Naegleria fowleri usually kills, there is no clear-cut answer. A life lived in fear is half lived, yet this amoeba is deadly. If you found this story to be scary, check out something that will make you a bit uncomfortable. Why do paper cuts hurt so much? Thanks for watching.